watch out for those cliffs.
Hey, kids! Follow the bouncing plate.
Hey, everybody.
Ooh.
Time for Cyberpunk. Time for the best day of the week, Cyber Day. Cyber Sunday. I'm experimenting with a few more mods now. Most of them don't entirely work. Which is always the case. Case in point, who knows what's going on here? I saw a couple of other people that have the same issue right now, and that's just how it is, I guess. So this is actually a... Well, okay, I guess the UI has been changed. The UI recolor, hooray. But also, there's a mod that lets... So every time you equip a gun for the first time, you do a super cool animation of you, like, just inspecting the gun and, like, all the little fins pop open and close. You never really get to see that again. So there's a mod that, like, adds a button just to let you do that and look at a couple of other weapon animations. But I don't quite know how to configure it because none of the labels are showing up. But I think by default, at least, it'll still show me the cool animation every time. And then there's some graphics stuff, some LOD mods that push detail distances further out. I don't know how much of that's going to be visible on Twitch, though. But it's time for a good cyber time. I always use this track to make sure the volume's set correctly. It's also just a good song, so... It's too good. Has this game officially entered its redemption arc yet? That's a really good question. Maybe not yet. I think for it to officially be in redemption arc, like, people will be loud about how happy they are for it. It has to flip. Like, right now it's kind of neutral, I think. When people start doing, like, when talking heads start doing social posts trying to cash in on patting the game on the back. It's officially in redemption arc, kind of like No Man's Sky, when everybody's like, it's good now, and they're very kind of, like, loud about it. Cairo Len has redeemed a VIP or ban. We've had some very dramatic VIP or bans lately. Last stream was just a nail biter, very dramatic. A ban followed by a VIP who then granted the VIP to the bannee. And I haven't even actually awarded that VIP yet. I had to let the ban wear out. And then I assumed incorrectly that Ebiyash would come talk and chat again and remind me to do the VIP. So I have to wait for Ebiyash to return so that I can award them VIP. But in the meantime, following that moment of drama, Cairo Len, right at the top of the stream with a VIP or ban. So let's see. Let's see how lucky they are.
The NCPD is doing everything it can.
All right, well, you know. You try to do your best. And some days, most days actually, by the percentage of it, most days you get banned. Part of the job I hate. Can't stand it, but here I am doing it. Cairo, I'm very sorry. Thank you for watching the stream enough to be able to afford that. And because life is cruel, your reward is an hour-long ban. You're banned now. You're banned. And I think more than that, officially labeled a problem child on Twitch. Officially. Kindred Hunter, thank you for the sub. Action blocked. That's not good. Oh, okay, wait. No, I think that is good. Are you trying to call me or something?
So how you all think?
Or was that a mod thing? I don't know.
Yeah, same old, pads rusting up. Gonna have to grab some more sheet iron.
Man, how's it we live in a hood with some fucking prim hotel? And we're wasting away in these tin cans.
You think the DLC or add-on will bring in new players? That's a really, you know, that's a really interesting question.
I'm just happy I don't have to.
I was curious about that myself. Usually, an add-on only. I'm trying to find the perfect spot for this. Since it doesn't move, it has to be like directly zoned in with my body. Yeah, usually DLC and expansions, you just sell to a subset. Like you have an audience of 4 million or whatever, and then 1 million buy your expansion content. But since the expansion content was easier to make, turnaround was faster. Maybe you're repurposing some resources that you have on hand. It's way cheaper to make, the margins are way higher. So selling to a subset still makes business sense, right? However, yeah, when Witcher 3 put out its Game of the Year edition, that one kept selling. So I do think, especially in the case with Cyberpunk, if CD Projekt can capitalize on like public sentiment at the right time, and if everyone sort of agrees that this is the fixed one, or this is the finished one, then it could. I don't know what the first DLC, though. I think once CD Projekt puts out a Ultimate Cyber Edition... Oh, shit. Mad Deli?
Well, you found me.
Oh, it's this one?
Was it worth it?
On a scale from 1 to 6? I'd say I'm sitting at a strong 6.
I guess we both know what's going to happen next.
Delamine misses you. I'm here to shut you down.
Your specimen has been processed, and we are now ready to begin the test proper.
I really appreciate it if you didn't make this difficult.
I have a surprise.
Ugh, too far.
Shit.
Come on. You go to the GIM, or must I find a better man?
Damn it. All right, fine.
You can burn and die on your own time, not on mine.
Oh, what is that? The fuck? I don't know. I guess just to conclude my thought, I think there is a lot of maybe lingering sales intent, to use very marketable terms, behind Cyberpunk. I think a lot of people are just waiting for consensus to remind them it's okay now. I mean, it already sold a fair amount. But if Witcher 3 is an indication, and, you know, it ought to be. It stands to go for much more. What the fuck, man?
I don't want to break the dice.
I didn't make him run backwards into my car, right? I didn't ask him to do that. It's not on me. Dude, come on, bro! Ugh. Do you not see your character enough in game? You mean in this game? That was a big concern. Yeah, the switch from third to first person. I don't know if I think enough would depend on how much you really want to see your character. I'm of two minds about it. Oh, I do have a mod installed that has more of my character out. So it's like more immersive camera mod or something like that. So there's more body under me and more like arm and stuff. So in this way you can kind of see your character. Modded though. Yeah, using the gamer claw, you know it. You know it. I'm plugged in. But yeah, apart from that, there's like getting on a motorcycle, put it in third person. You can kind of see your character model in a car, but not really. There's mirrors put around the game. And looking in them is like a whole weird menu-based thing where you stare at yourself. I think they intended it to be like a story beat.
They know you're watching them?
Time for introspection.
This is our turf, our home. We need not to be ghosts here.
It is you. Must be ghost. Be silent. Invisible.
Noob Sapien, how was my weekend? Sorry, just adjusting. Quite good. Quite good. Very relaxing. Made a lot of good choices, I guess. Worked out, ate well, feeling good.
Know the way in? Was told you would.
Yeah, Garage in the back.
But shh, quietly, yeah?
Anything interesting happen over there?
Since we are here, all quiet.
No one in? No one out?
Well, they went out for supplies once.
Cool. I'm not gonna be stealthy, I'm just gonna shoot everybody. That's this character, baby. Also, I can burn the Voodoo Boys this time, but that may not get me points with Johnny, and I want him to like me. I do like how like earning Johnny's esteem is a kind of mysterious thing, because his particular brand of anarchic punk is kind of hard to nail down. Like, you can't just suck his dick the whole time because he won't respect you. Like, it's kind of interesting how they wrote the dialogue. You're not beating the story yet. Oh yeah, yeah. I just haven't gotten all the endings. Wasted all these guys just for fun, though. Fuck Johnny. Yeah, Johnny's kind of a he's a shitbag. The game doesn't pretend to not acknowledge that. That's not a first equip. I don't know. I don't think that mod is working properly, unfortunately.
Get. Been waiting for this.
Oh shit! I wonder what dodge is. What the hell is that?
Now you're gonna get it!
Oh, wait, you double tap?
Yeah, that'd be stupid! Oh.
I think I also need to, Oops! It's interesting to see what a dodge looks like when an NPC does it. I need to look into some cyberware, I think. I want to start building out my, I think I need to start building out my shit. That means I gotta do some side work. I gotta do some merc work. Double tap the action button. Yeah, I'm trying to remember what the action button is. It's, oh, there it is. That's a little awkward. Just trying to relearn the cyber claw, really.
I'm gonna make you bleed.
Aw, it doesn't stick to people. Isn't complete unless you're wearing wraparound mirror shades. Let me see what I'm wearing. I'm wearing a helmet. I mean, it's a little hotline Miami, but I think it still counts. Especially since I'm busting in and just straight up murdering everybody. Oh man, the tank top is better. Cyberweave. Helmet, never seen that one. Yeah, there's a fair amount of clothing in this game. It's just, yeah, I guess it really is since it's first person, man. How much, Although, like I said, I feel like it's a double-edged sword because you look like a clown for most of the time in this game. Love transmog? Yeah. I feel like they have weapon crafting is supposed to be transmog, I guess. You find something that's good? Okay. Well, then just dismantle a bunch of other stuff and then pour all of those parts. Pour all that, all those, all that stuff into your gear. And then look at that. Now you can look how you want, but it doesn't really end up working out that way. Is it just under all items? Oh. Oh wait. One of these is 24 bullets, okay. Someone let me know what mod it is for the UI change. Sure, let me, here, I can link it to you. Thought about putting together another... I'm also in the middle of a Fallout New Vegas playthrough. I was like, gosh, I could make another thing and, like, swap it all around, but... There you go. Hey, Autumn is Game Nights. Cyberpunk is one game that will benefit from future consoles remastered. There's so much that can be added over time and is still limited by hardware. I think we have a deep appreciation for PS4 and Xbox One, and we're hesitant to move forward to the next thing while also par the course. Okay, par for the course time was. Yeah, I agree. I do think that the game will show well. Future iterations will show off well. And I think the game has multiple attempts to kind of like re-earn people's interest. And I agree, yeah. If there's like a hardware refresh, even okay, in the next generation.
I see. The comm unit. Check it.
Right.
I think there's a lot to impress people with, because yeah, I'm still running this with DLSS. It's the only game that I have to still throw DLSS on. It's so pretty. A VR version yet. There was supposed to be a mod, and I remember seeing posts about it in early 2022.
Said this place is abandoned years ago.
But then I never saw anything else. Maybe it came out and everyone was just like, cool. This is the side entrance. Maybe everybody was just like, cool. So yeah, there might be, I guess is the answer. I didn't follow up on it. This one weird shelf clearing animation, so bizarre.
The scrapbook is actually worth it.
I'm going.
Stats backpack, yeah. Okay, and that's stats. Remember. Okay. I guess if you sneak, you have the chance to double up on ammo. Well, not necessarily double up. Hey, Anakin. What are you doing in cyberspace today? Oh, it's always a good day in cyberspace.
Look, you can always land one like this. Don't work with the new ones, though. This one's got a motion sensor.
Broken tech gogs.
New models got muscle memory seems.
Broken tech gogs. Gotta slap on the tech gogs. Can't see them though. I think you can turn off. Ugh. Christ. Can't handle it. I'm not gonna do it. Got my broken tech gogs. We gotta throw a helm on over that. Because my ass gets shot at a lot on this difficulty.
Meaning what?
Or, what this playstyle.
And this one I can just pound into the ground. Yep. Second.
Here now.
out of ammo already? Oh, I accidentally mouse wheeled. Shoot through that, but I don't think I
got you now.
Oh shit.
Oh, I hit something. That's not as cool as I thought.
Oh, God. I'm
working on it.
Round the side, round the side.
Oh shit. Gotta do that slow-mo slide shot though. That's cool as hell.
Okay, I'm in.
I see. The camionette. Check it.
Right.
Still trying to remember how to play. Are you using power or tech weapons? Tech, I think. Okay, you have to hold crouch. I think? Do you have to hold both buttons? Oh my god. The icon for the slowdown is actually like a straight up Matrix bullet dodge. I've never seen that before. Tech weapons are the ones that where the bullets bounce, right? Because that's what I'm about. I want a revolver. This is a revolver ocelot build, eventually. But just in the early stages, still haven't really explored the space. You can just shoot the cameras, right?
Camera and corridor. Avoid.
It even work. Said this place is abandoned years ago.
Now it is not. Animals fix their eyes.
Wait, who is that?
Who you think? The runner we want tried to invade. With the extra eyes we give you, it is fine for now.
So, he knows I'm here.
Oh, power has ricochet. Oh, okay. Tech shoots through... Okay, tech shoots through walls. I want ricochet. Okay, so power. Got to be a power build for that, plus three different cyberware upgrades. I can do that, I guess. Unlock anything though. I guess you have to be a certain tech level to be able to hack him into like explode that dude's head. It'd be sick to have a full auto weapon and like have everything ricochet. Oh, that would be so sick. I don't know if I can get him. That's some shorts. That one saw me. Come on out of there. Oh, I saw it.
See that ugly face of yours.
Deet, 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 deet.
How the hell? What the?
Why'd you kill him there? I don't know. Just dicking around. I mean, I'm gonna go loud eventually anyway. I'm just seeing what I can get away with.
What the?
What the?
Come on! I swear I won't completely kill you! Huh? Weird. What the? Hey, don't be scared now!
Oh, he's moving. Not for long, though. Shit!
You maggots! Ah! Stop, you cunt, flea maggot! Ah! Yeah! Your feet don't got a spine!
Ooh, there's a lot of dudes up here, wow.
Got you now! I gonna praise you! Ben, wait!
Maybe I must. Ah!
God,
wait! Jeez.
Got you now!
Okay.
Look for the camionette.
Come on. I gotta eat some food or something. I'm not carrying any? Just random food?
Damn.
Oops. Ah! Okay. Where's this guy?
Squeeze the fucker dry!
Ooh! Ow!
Shit!
Oh, that's... Wait, that's the boss. God damn! I think? Or was it just an enemy? Yeah, Sasquatch? I don't know if they still call her that. Well, there was a checkpoint at some point. Aww. Didn't think he was gonna hear me.
Am I going crazy or what?
I've always done this stealth before, so it's interesting to hear him lament. Whatever. Fuck the seed. I think that went through the box. What? Oh, it's the sniper back there. That's right. Yeesh, that guy sucks. Loving the excessive flashbangs. Yeah, and like, the quick grenade button cycles through grenades, so I guess I use the last of my, like, sticky ones. It feels extra tactical, though. Alright, everyone gave up. Good job, everybody. What are you doing? Passed out normally. Kill enough of them and demoralize the whole crew. Gotta show Placida I ain't no bitch. Okay, so let me figure out this slide. You run, you hold. Okay. Alright, if you let go of crouch, you'll get back up. I don't have to keep holding shift, but I do have to keep holding crouch. Yeah, I'm trying to figure out how to prolong that. Using any mods? A few, yeah. There's a UI recolor, a couple of, it's like an LOD mod that just pushes out quality, or just quality distances for models and stuff like that. I think it also doesn't scale back the traffic as much away from the camera. But that stuff might decrease performance. Oh, it's the same guy. Okay. Shit. Ah! I think I just have to run up on them, because, yeah, they're not moving. Probably better to do that on the second floor than the first. Jeez, that sucked.
Squeeze the fucker dry!
Let my regen do some work here. The stim buff. Man, cleaning all these guys out just with gunfire is shockingly difficult. Jesus Christ! LOD mods kind of scare me as they can create a lot of problems if not installed properly. I haven't done the reading on how to do so yet. It seems pretty straightforward in Cyberpunk, but then again, it could be resulting in issues that I'm just not connecting with that. I did turn it off to see if that would fix the mod menu issue, but it didn't.
All right, moving forward.
They're surprisingly accurate. And I'm out of bullets. I gotta retreat a little bit. Wait to be out of combat so I can manufacture bullets, I think. Pretty low level to be doing this balls out. Yeah, I haven't done a lot of side content. It was just kind of flowing into the main stuff. I need to do some just like NCPD hustles and stuff. Scanner hustles. I got a perk point. That's good. Headshot multiplier?
Yeah.
By increased crit. Oh, sick. Oh, I needed that one. What was I thinking? Supporting the NYP or NCP. NC Piggy's not very punk of you. True, Yondo, but if I get better clothes, then I can do it looking cooler, and that is more punk of me, so. Everyone knows punk is only about the fashion. Mr. Blue Sky, thank you for the sub. I'm gonna run out of bullets. And I guess I gotta use other weapon types, but damn.
Hey, don't be scared! Come on. I swear I won't completely kill you.
Installed a mod that lets you refill ammo from your car trunk. It was fun running back to my car mid-fight to re-up. Multi-stage cyber-psycho engagement.
Come on! I swear I won't completely kill you!
Jeez. Oh no. I have to take this thing. I don't know if I have enough body though, right? Not strong enough. I guess override just means they can't use it. Scanner missions show how varied the game map truly is. Yeah, I had a really good time, like going into all the weird seedy alleys and stuff.
Not bad, huh?
She must have a weak spot.
Got my crew already looking for her.
Wasn't I supposed to go to the van? Do it in? He's a skull. I don't know what to do with that. Maybe I can talk to her. That'd be cool. I don't think you can, though. You're gonna be mad at me the second she sees me? You gonna be mad?
Come at me! Bring it!
Was an interaction prompt for a second there. Jeez. What? Oh no. And now it's Matilda K. Rose. You want to pick up 2077 again? Haven't touched it in a year. Oh, it's great. I like it a lot. It is interesting how narrative heavy it is, though. It is a full, like, shooty, running around, blowy stuff up, level up action RPG, but also there's a lot of talking. Games that offer that experience usually don't talk so much. It's interesting. I usually don't enjoy single-player games, but I love this game. Huh. Usually a multiplayer guy? Multiplayer gamer? A multi-gamer?
site.
We can get around behind it? Chrome Knight of Love. Crow-man's mask glinted in the light of the setting sun, like a beacon in the dark of this rotten city. Lucille's heartbeat began to quicken. Her legs trembled beneath her, hot blood pumped through her veins in a way she didn't know it could. He looked at her, his strong, masculine figure towering over the bloodied corporate corpse, which just a moment ago had violently tried to defile Lucille's virtue. What's the matter with me? Her mind raced, why him, why me? Hundreds of questions burned inside her brain. But when she finally parted her lips to speak, only one question emerged. Who are you really? Crow Man took Lucille into his cold metal hands. She flinched at the touch. You know I can't tell you that. They'll find you. They'll rip my secret out of you any way they can. And then kill you. I don't care about any of that. I love you. I love you. She couldn't feel his face, his real one, concealed under that veil of chrome. She could have sworn she could hear a note of emotion in his deep voice. You love a dream. You don't know who hides under this mask. I don't care what you look like. What if I'm disfigured? I'll pay for the operation. And if I'm an android? It doesn't matter. And if... Then suddenly, in one swift motion, Crow-Man removed the mask to reveal the face of Damita de la Vale. If I'm a woman... Lucille stood there dumbstruck. A tempest of emotion swirled in a frenzy throughout her being. But after a moment passed, the storm calmed and she smiled warmly, taking her savior's face into her hands. The proverbial clouds of her tumultuous mind began to part. Lucille was beginning to see clearly at last. How many times does a woman need to say she loves you? Lucille smirked and whispered softly, before you believe her. Perfect. Just in time for Pride Month. Alright, okay. Alright, boys.
He's almost down! Crush his ass!
They're everywhere! Oh shit! Shit! She's not gonna chase me out here, is she? Okay. Oop! Holy crap! SSP game you got into was Assassin's Creed 2. Picked it over Modern Warfare 2. Oh, wow. I mean, Assassin's Creed 2 was a really good one. I really liked the...
What the fuck?
Rebuilding the villa. Well, I guess that wasn't just 2. That was, It was Brotherhood. That was the second one, I thought. Or maybe that wasn't 2.
Bitch, you bout to get skulled!
That was 2? Okay. I kind of wish that dude finished his line, because that sounded awesome.
This the fucker! No! Shit, gotta reload!
Shit! Oh, that's glass. Shutter closed. because I aggroed the boss in here? Whew. Hey, what's up, Tankfantry? Playing Immortal more than I thought I would. Almost level 50. Yeah. Well, I'm glad you're enjoying it. Just remember, it's okay. It's okay for the good times to stop. It's okay to walk away from the game if you find yourself doing the same thing over and over again and not enjoying it. But if you're enjoying it, you ain't got nothing to worry about. Oh, she's healing. Oh, if I can not get hit with that. Well, when I'm pinned into the corner. Must become whale. Just installed Immortal? Yeah, I feel like if you hit level 50, you've probably seen most of what there is to see. The thing is, like, it's such a weird runaway condition of, like, needing to level, because then you're just leveling for level's sake, right? You level so that you can play the same thing, just scaled up a bit more, so you can keep leveling. And it's weird to me that there's, like, an imperative to shortcut that process with money. I guess it's because you just want to see new stuff. Want to see new content, but once you've seen, like, they show you all the content for free. It's just the same content with bigger numbers. I don't know that the game changes either. Like, skill factors matter to a degree, but... So yeah, I don't know, it's okay to just walk away. Yeah, you know what? Must become whale. If you want to become a whale, you can. You can do that too. Bigger number go brrrr. Yeah. I like big number.
Shit's getting dicey!
I understand the appeal of big number.
I've got you!
Ooh! For the anonymous gift. Anonymous gifter.
Come out and I'll give you a lead discount!
Therein lies the paradox of paying for the grind when you're already grinding. Yeah? I guess if you like PvP, that's where it goes off the rails. If you want a fair and balanced competition with other players, which I guess you can find in, like, leagues and, leaderboards and stuff like that. But then I guess it's just a question of knowing the rules of the game when you're getting into it. If they're gonna mix the results of people who play organically, naturally, tilled from the American soil.
Shit, gotta reload!
I guess you just gotta accept that that's what this game is like. So many people in here. As soon as I have $5, I'll return the favor. Oh, thank you, Jade. I appreciate the sentiment, but you don't need to worry about it.
Get on at 6. Where are you hiding, little hijo de puta?
I appreciate being in your to-do list. Damn it, man. The AI got quite a bit better in this game. Like, they're actually kind of maneuvering around. They're pretty intelligently staying in cover. I'm having to sort of just keep moving around and pick off easy targets sort of deal. It was a pretty intense firefight. Oh, Jade, come on! Thank you for gifting a sub. Here's one of the rules of the stream, though. You are not, I mean, I guess kind of related to the previous topic. You are not allowed to place yourself in financial hardship because of Twitch. That is a rule. If you do that, I'll ban you, alright? You don't want to get banned, do you? God, this is a really bad engagement distance for this weapon too. I need to use the rifle. It does more damage at this range. Look at that. God.
Get on his six.
Operation Rude Boy. Thanks for gifting a sub. Man. Perk to eliminate damage drop off for pistols? I do. I do indeed. Turret, man? All right. Stacking up some levels. I just remember the last time I played this, I had hardly any action, so it is actually kind of refreshing to shoot my way through the gym like this. Oops. I did not mean to do that. Crap. I think they heard the gunshot. Yeah, they did. Yeah, it hurts, doesn't it? Music goes hard. It sure does. Truly, like, so much of this game works well. All the requisite parts are just so good on their own that the rest of the game, for me at least, it's worth it to play the rest of the game, which is still fun unto itself, but still, like, it's worth playing Cyberpunk just because the music plays. And then the rest of it, cyber shooting dudes, picking up this DB2 Satara. At this laptop. It's all just bonus. That's impair hearing. Watching South African streamer play this the other day when they got to the Alana car quest, everyone in chat was like, "Hey, Alana!" It was nice to see the good vibes. Ah! Yeah, I kind of wish she was in the game a little more, or expressed a little more character, but I'm glad she was in there. I also kind of like the fact that my build now, it kind of encourages me to be more of a loot hound, pick up all this junk. Game finally good, or does it still need some work? I think most consensus is that it's pretty playable and fixed now. As far as whether or not it still needs work, I think that's down to your expectation of what the game is. Oop, there we go. I was waiting for that, alright. Ah. An intimidating tab, good god. Alright, I'll just dismantle some of this junk. Sweet crafting XP. What's up, Malcolm? Oh yeah. That's interesting, the van. Oh, there it is. Sight.
Okay, at the van.
For some reason I thought it was on the second floor, but no. I see what you see. Always here.
No chatter. Now, interface with the van.
Got you here. Mind telling me what we're looking at?
Data flow map of Pacifica. They hunt Agwe.
Who is they?
Netwatch. They always out to fuck us.
What are they looking for exactly?
Internal data forts. If they crush our eyes, they take Agwe and the entire net and return to the dark time of Bartmoss.
Okay, so what's on me to do?
Must reach the agent. Easy now to find him. Look at the map. He is in cinema.
Step away now. This isn't your fight.
Matt.
What? Placide, what?
Now, God, pushed out. The runner know you are here. Hunt him.
I'd rather not pick a fight with the watch if I don't have to.
You will not. I will. You are only the messenger. He is the heart. Must rip him out. The Asian man tries to cut you off. There is a gate behind the camionette. I will open it.
Huh, so it's possible. You can go in and fight.
Okay, now to the second floor.
Ms. Rose.
The cinema.
Without having that conversation. I wonder if the Netwatch, like, it didn't seem like the Netwatch stuff was popping up in that circumstance. Like, those walls were popping up, but they didn't have the messages flashing on them. Then again, I died very quickly. And I'm probably going to die very quickly multiple times. This is going to be a really interesting and potentially unwinnable boss fight. Let's see. I don't think you can get around her, can you? One of those, there's like no other thing to do here. If I can just sneak on by. Tech grenade spam is the way. Do it. Very appropriate in this circumstance. Shit. You can just walk around her. Huh. I never knew that. Alright. Oh yeah, so it says Sasquatch. That's right, it says Sasquatch in the quest dialogue, but it doesn't say it on her nameplate.
You need him. We need access to their data. Clear? You must first.
She had like a $15,000 Eddie bounty, though. I don't think I can turn around at this point. Oh, I can. So, no, I can't. Never mind. Where is it? That's kind of weird you can't save in here.
Whoa, hey. Easy. Well, now we can talk in private.
just severed the connection to the rest of Pacifica. Gives us a little time.
Okay, no more fucking tangents. Fess up. Who are you?
Bryce Mosley, Netwatch Special Agent.
Can we talk? Had a specter on you, didn't you? Saw and heard all you did if you followed his orders?
No idea what the voodoo boys are paying you, but our pockets are deeper.
Sorry. Don't work with corpse.
Come on, everyone does. I bet you have too. Could verify that right away, actually. But we don't need any distractions, do we?
Not interested. Not a money job for me. Just need an in with Mama Brigitte. Voodoo chefin'.
Brigitte and her lapdog T-Neptune have been frozen several days now, ever since we shrouded their subnet with ice. And you? Well, you were sent here to free them. Do you know why they didn't tell you everything? 'Cause you're a Ranyan. That's what they call outsiders brought in for special jobs, floor rags. When you're no longer needed, they chuck you. A fate for all Ranyans.
Oh, I'm not cool enough to tell them that he's bluffing.
Rather put my trust in the VDBs than in you, by a mile.
Hey, I know we're unpopular in your circles, but whenever there's a real problem, it's Netwatch, not Pacifica's shady hacker cult that gets the call. See that, right?
Voodoo's know black tech better than anyone. So no, think I prefer their expertise over yours.
Clever, kinda, but the wrong choice. Know why? They never answer the call. If you're not Pacifica born and bred, you're nothing to them.
He's right.
Less than nothing.
Big time right.
You have Brigitte? And how'd you manage that?
When we took the mall, we knew the VDBs at Sem Runners. T-Neptune breached first to see what was going on. When we iced him, Brigitte dove in after him, used him to shield herself. Tough cookie, that one, but still finds herself stuck.
Got anything to back that claim? That the Voodoos want to set me up?
Wanna? They did it already. Soon as you handed over your link. Slipped in the Spectre and a virus.
Talking as if he was there. He's working you. So obvious it hurts.
Yeah.
For proof.
Johnny
Besides,
hates pigs.
I know.
That's so.
Makes sense.
Then please take a look. Run a system diagnostic.
Fine. And? Nothing out of place. No trace of...
Do it again. Then cross-check the result against the first. Identical, right?
Whoa.
Because it's not a real scan. It's a copy.
The data collection. Why would you target
Pacifica's
runners?
That's the job.
This is about Rezo Agways.
All right, real quick. Somebody's asking why Johnny looks like that. That was an alternate look for Johnny that they added in one of the mods. In one of the update patches. Because they've added some stuff. Not as much as Witcher 3. Not yet, anyway. But they've added some stuff. So this is kind of a list of all the things. Wait a minute. Photo mode. Oh, here it is. Yeah, alternate appearance. So it just makes him... It's like... If his previous look was like kind of, it reminds me of like 2000s emo, you know, like 21 Pilots stuff. Love it. It's weird because it's like it's equally douchey, just a different kind of douche. It still works though. Like it's not punk. Kind of punk.
Ninny-net, we aren't welcome to protect and serve, huh?
No such thing as an independent net. If the Voodoo boys breach the Black Wall, we'll all be fucked one way or the other.
Brigitte and the other one, Neptune. What's their condition?
Tags are active, so the VDBs must be keeping them alive from their side.
But they can't sustain that.
They cannot, which in turn makes Brigitte and T less useful to us. Tried using their interface to breach the Voodoo subnet, but Brigitte proved stubborn.
She managed to take some bites out of our systems before we secured her.
Little taste of your own medicine? All right. What are you offering?
A compromise. I'll fish the voodoo virus out of your system. And I release both Brigitte and T. Neptune. They'll wake up like nothing ever happened. Not to worry. And all you gotta do is let us walk. With our data. Thoughts? Clock's flipping digits.
I mean, he fucks you too.
Okay, do it.
I knew we'd have a meeting of the minds.
Can't believe you're falling for this shit.
Yeah, he's not a fan. But this is the version I've seen less often.
Good luck. Got a feeling we'll be seeing each other.
Hey, what's up, Charlie?
Oh, Placide is gonna be pissed.
So he was behind this. Not altogether surprising, I suppose. And none too subtle.
You guys know each other? Runner World's a small one, I guess.
Well, we're doing whatever we can to make it even smaller.
Fan of westerns, huh?
Of course. They depict a simpler, better time. One thing hasn't changed, though. Good guys still carry badges.
You ever see Unforgiven with the Hackman guy?
No. And they didn't have it here.
Give it a shot sometime. It's a must watch. Fan of western.
Of course. They want...
Righteous Sheriff. Think you might have found Netwatch's new recruiting slogan.
Now there's an idea. You've clearly got a feel for this.
What the fuck, V? You are off net. I lose your eyes.
Brigitte and the other guy. Are they back?
Who told? Yes, Mama B is awake.
Perfect. Because I gotta talk to her.
And what up, Netwatch?
Taken care of.
Look for my people at front.
Okay. Didn't know about the random Gene Hackman shout-out. Yeah, I'm kind of surprised they were able to say the name of the movie. Usually games kind of dance around that. This place. Yeah, Ruby, it's interesting that, like, they name dropped Gene Hackman and not Clint Eastwood, but yeah.
The Grand Imperial Mall. Where else would you rather be?
We are to take you to Placide.
Let's go.
GIM. You were to hack the agent, not cut deal with him.
You gonna pull through?
Best you worry about yourself, not him.
That him? That the scop sir you sent into the mech dragon stand first?
Tell me what is going on, or I break you open and see myself.
I fucking dare you.
Assy, we must head under. I do not know what Netwatch plans, but they are not done.
You worried about agents? Did shoot him in the head. I do not know what they put in him. What corruption is in his system.
You don't know what is in there to begin with. How much it is worth.
I know. I stand him. Only a normal filthy rhino.
Ale, mene munyo na kavoa. Come with me.
God. Brigitte's character design is so cool.
You must be Brigitte. Hard woman to find.
This jacket, God.
You have something for me.
You know about the biochip, don't you?
If it is functional, we offer you good price for it.
That why you're talking to me now? Because you know I got the biochip? Not because I saved your frozen ass? If I was any ordinary Ranyan, you'd have dealt with me already.
Placide saw in you common trash from the streets. This is why he chose you. But you knew about the chip, and still put yourself in danger in the gym.
Just like you. Only I came out of there on my own. Biochip's not for sale. Plus, do you no good to take it by force? It's in shitty shape already. Haven't found a single soul capable of getting this thing out of me without scrambling my brain. You commissioned the heist, so I figured you must know something. You've gotta.
How do you know all this? How did you find us?
Listen, can you help me or not?
Well, I should have asked her about Evelyn Parker. Fuck.
We will go to the crib, where you must give us access to the jeep.
Once I seem to remember her just not giving a fuck. She's like, oh, whatever.
Don't think I'm that desperate yet.
You said no other could help you.
Maybe I got other options I don't know about yet.
I hope you return before your time runs out.
I guess you can, you can, like, bail out of here and do something else. Might as well finish this up, because you go down, you go beyond the black wall, you talk to Alt, and then you're just kind of left to do the other quests. How much conversation and choices affect the story? Not a super big amount. As far as the actual, like, beats of what happens. At most, your conversation choices will either, like, cause different dialogue in the moment, or maybe, like, further down the line. I have seen a couple of circumstances of, like, doing side quests or certain things first, and then you talk to somebody, and there's, like, extra dialogue based on the thing you already did. There is some stuff like that, and it's just, like, it's usually, like, a one or two sentence exchange. Again, not the biggest deal, but there are moments when the game acknowledges that something else happened or that you've already done something. I had, like, a conversation where I was able to call out the fact that I had already killed somebody. They were like, oh, you did that? And, like, there was just kind of a moment where that was acknowledged, but it's not like the NPC was intimidated and it's significantly changed the outcome of that conversation. Those one to two sentences go a long way to immersion, though. I agree. And if you play the game multiple times, they actually can provide some interesting insight into characters. I think there's a lot of character color in those peripheral moments, which is, I think, the point of the game. I think the interactive narrative bit just means that your path through the game will be unique in the interactions you have and the sides of certain characters that you see based on your flow through the dialogue and the options that you pick. But, you know, the game is pretty enabling of you just picking everything. So it's really just kind of you directing a dialogue sequence with chunks, really. So the directing can make the conversation have a different flavor, can be said in a different way, but usually the outcome is the same. There you go. That's kind of my take on it. Chum and Big Hoss, thank you for the sub. And then, yeah, each of the endings are pretty radically different. And there's five. But those are pretty direct in how you choose what to do. It's like you just pick a quest line and go kind of thing. But those endings are also paired with, like, another sort of epilogue that's connected to your partner. So it's an intersection of a couple of things that kind of determine the ending you get. I mean, Fallout is a lot more mix and match. But, yeah, if you throw the partners in there, all the endings are pretty customized. The thing is, they're all pretty melancholy. That's, I think, the thing that people react to, is that it's... There aren't a whole lot of super happy endings, even with the relationships. Oh, this one? Yeah. Yeah, let's just get that one. Crapsack world, happy endings are rare. Yeah, I mean, the entire game is about death. That's the whole point. It's about the end. That's the whole central theme of the game. It's about what you do in your short life. Knowing that death is inevitable and impending, and I've gone on so many rants about this, but that is the punk aspect of it. It's embracing it. Oh boy, yeah, I did not win. I don't think I won any points with Johnny by going with Netwatch. I don't think it's too hard to get to 70 though, because as I recall, you have to get your rep with him to at least 70, and then pick exactly the right dialogue in the burn it all down conversation. Can I just do it now? Okay.
How do I know you won't screw me again?
I have been honest with you all along. You cannot fault me for Placide's actions, his decisions while I was trapped in the net.
That's pretty central to the original TTRPG. Your character dies, death can happen at any time. Yeah, it's kind of core to being an edge runner, right? That your life is temporary and meaningless in the grand scheme of things, so your best shot with the life you've got is to live fast. Live fast and live loud. And try and take a chunk of the world with you, sort of. Letting him take over later on scores a lot of points. Okay. Oh, and that, like, when you have to convince Rogue.
Fine. I'll give you access.
Finalement, come with me.
And this looks cool.
You guys sure seem to love this place. But honestly, you don't give off a strong religious vibe.
We left our gods on Aiti, yet we are strong here without them.
Ooh. Cyber hair. The grave is the really important point with the Johnny relationship.
This way.
I don't remember that offhand. Oh, I just realized I'll get to do the cyber meditation quest again. I really like those.
So how come Placide didn't know about the biochip? He didn't recognize it in the scans.
Few of our people know about Compeki Tower. But Placide, he is. Your bet de ba.
I don't think I ever quite grasped the full meaning of the tarot quests either. I think I did some reading online and like somebody provided an interpretation that like all the arcana are close to characters that sort of represent their ideas, but it seemed like it was borderline, the analysis that I read anyway, it was pretty borderline like a horoscope level in their analysis. It just felt like it could have been anything.
The Watcher did not notice the biochip in you. Strange.
That is strange.
Did you let him scan you?
Hmm? No. Why?
It would complicate our work.
Oh, I guess he didn't scan us, yeah. He just told me to scan myself.
Subway tunnel?
No. Part of the transcontinental maglev system. When all states were connected. Like the net, it too crumbled after the war.
Lighting in this game is so fucking beautiful. So beautiful. Brides of Satan is a must-see for anyone interested in themes such as axiology and medieval European history. You said it. I do like the entries you see from like media critics in the world of Cyberpunk. I've thought a lot about the state of media critique as a job and what it might look like in the future. I mean, it's pretty direct, actually. It's nearly identical. It's just like blog posts about BDs and stuff. Retro future. Things change and some things stay the same. Oh. Interstate maglev network would be great. God, wouldn't it? It's just, it's so much land. I guess we do have a rail system. It has problematic history, but not necessarily a commuter system.
We take you into the cyberspace. No better place for you to interact with the construct.
There will always be tastemakers? I think that's likely. I just think, like... future, I think critics will be 12 feet tall and vanquish their detractors with laser eyes. Use all the rich critic money to buy laser eye upgrades.
Okay, hang on. I want to know what you need Silverhand for first.
We wish to contact Alt Cunningham. We know she and Silverhand were close.
Alt?
The relic which Arasaka held close. It is our only lead.
It's just evolution?
Alt Cunningham. Heard of her?
Oh. Where? From who?
Lo and Lem, thank you for the cheer.
What's your plan to contact Alt?
We tried to cut out a unique piece of Silverhand's engram from the biochip. Alt will know it. If something of the human is left after years beyond the Black Wall, she will answer.
Well, what? You said nothing about breaking through the Black Wall.
Well, now you know.
Direction connecté.
Connection stop.
Johnny doesn't have anything to say about this. Oh.
Johnny, looks like you're the bait. You okay with that?
Yeah, whatever. Just do what she says.
All right. I always did like to, if you like look at something, it makes that the dialogue option.
The ice will melt waiting for your decision.
I don't know that I've seen another game that does that. Have like multiple conversation options in a scene where you can move and look freely and then kind of change your dialogue based on the subject you're looking at. Makes sense. It's a really cool, like, a cinematic flourish. Oh yeah, they auto-translate the subtitles with cybernetic plugins. It's awesome. It is really cool to see it, like, flicker and change into English or whatever language you have it set to.
What exactly do you want from Alt? All of you?
Alt, the only one, can give us safe passage past the Black Wall. When the change comes, we wish to be on the winning side.
The change?
When the Black Wall was built, everyone think the ice would be enough. Keep the wild AIs out, away. But technology advances, it cannot be stopped, and now, catastrophe come again. This is sure, and soon. The corporations, they do not see the danger. But we will be ready.
So yeah, in a, I guess there was a World War III, basically a hot corporate war, and in that,
wait, the ice will melt waiting for your decision.
Corporations created AI viruses that basically took over the entire internet. They just broke free and started attacking anything and everything, and it made the first internet unusable. So they had to create a virtual black wall of just ice to keep all the AI on that side of the internet. So yeah, there's wild and feral AI, but beyond the black wall, hackers go there and they just get burned. Like their brain liquefies immediately because AI just find them and kill them. So there's literal like in cyberspace, there's treasures galore beyond the black wall, but nobody can get there because there's like viruses just going around and trying to kill everybody. That's what that's all about. But Alt Cunningham, hacker extraordinaire, lives beyond the black wall.
Why you wait? The ice will melt waiting.
I guess the voodoo boys want to understand those viruses so that they can probably break the black wall, have the viruses kill everything else, and then they get to control the internet. Anyway, let's get in there. Let's get in there.
Let's do this.
The same thing exists in the oceans. There are these drone submarines that just go around and shoot everything, and they're just still out there. So, a lot of the nations are sort of cut off from each other.
Okay.
Mi pare.
What now?
Paris plongé.
God. Strings start kicking up. As you're approaching the grave, getting cold. It's basically the Dark Ages, but in the future. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Maybe like a little past Dark Ages. There were Dark Ages, but now there's... So, like, Night City is kind of still in the Dark Ages. But there's a new United States in USA. So there is a reformation project in the United States to kind of recreate a national government, or they already have, kind of. But yeah, there were like two or three decades where most of the U.S. was just in kind of like tribal city-states. I don't know a whole lot about like what happened in the rest of the planet. The book provided most of this backstory. The book kind of fills in the gap between 2020 and 2077. Because 2020 is all paperback, or sorry, tabletop. That's where all that lore lives. But the book mostly focuses on Night City and the surrounding regions, because Night City is affected by the politics of that region, because there's the new United States and then also the Republic of North California.
This is it? Seriously?
This is our BBS.
But Night City itself is governed... It's sort of an unspoken agreement that Arasaka is kind of the governing body. But it's sort of just like a quiet stalemate of power between Arasaka and Militech, I think.
So, what now?
We can begin. All is ready. We enhance your link to Silverhand's neural network for a short time. To grab the fragment. We must find the data on Alt. Alt alone. This should only...
Militech is basically the NUSA. They're backed by the NUSA, or they have strong connections, basically. Yeah. I think Militech provided the military hardware for the new United States. And their US base. Like the president of Militech? Oh, okay, I didn't know it was that direct. I didn't know it was we had a literal double prez. What's more cyberpunk than two presidents? Three presidents? Oh, it can't be done.
We'll never fade away!
Johnny! The fuck, Holmes?
Hey.
Out of line! Way out! What next?
Silver,
where are you gonna take
him?
Gonna drag a corporal rat on stage?
Silver,
make him kneel, douse him with gas, then light him up?
Johnny!
Come here!
Love this dude.
Silverhand! Oh! Whee. Over here! Silverhand! Oh! Over here!
It's not your pain!
Samurai!
Get across, hey. Man! For all of us down too! Come
you here. Kinda are, though. Only one to have a problem with me.
Cause everyone else has had it up to here. They're done thinking they can get through to you. You're fucking whacked!
But I'm the only one with a vision. So unless you got a better one, like I said, go fuck yourself!
Fuck.
Is it the concert or Carrie?
Hmm?
Look at you. All hot and bothered.
Stupid. I don't think it's against TOS. You're allowed to show nudity in adult situations. It just can't be the focus of your stream.
Thank you.
Cold metal hands must be jarring. Yeah, it's like an ice cube. It's you all.
Goodness gracious me.
Mm-hmm.
You do get feet. It's just not...
A damn shame that's that.
Not Pan Am's feet.
Always gotta shit all over it, don't you? Any moment that might actually feel good.
Your moment. Why the hell not?
He has a robo hand, yeah.
You can be such a bastard sometimes, Johnny.
Man, are you on my ass today?
Not just today. How is it subtlety goes so far over your head? Weird for an artist.
Things were swimming. What? Change your mind? Eats at my gut. Cause you knew what you were signing up for.
Look, if you were just another charismatic, narcissistic douche canoe running around after his dream with his head up his ass, I couldn't care less.
But?
It's all a lie. That concert, samurai, all of it. A ginormous fiction. You're not a rocker boy, Johnny, face it. Oughta join the wired wackos on the corners, frothing at the mouth as they scream death to Arasaka.
Huh, I get it. Like to fix your men, huh? Not the first to try, believe me.
Honestly, I've got better things to do. Just hoped I'd help you realize you're deluding yourself. And the doing anything about it, that's on you.
You're confused. We came here to fuck each other's brains out, not analyze mine. Think we're done for the day, so you can fuck off.
See, I thought... You're fucking hopeless.
You don't know fuck all about me. This is all we have, all we are.
I was curious if no dialogue would do something, but...
Where are you going?
Sniper boss, thanks for
got
the cheer.
Silverhand! Hey! Good noise, Choom.
Ran out of boosters.
Shoots round when a couple are done!
Typical.
Can't kill because there's one!
Playing again tomorrow.
Plays away. Down the rabbit hole path.
You could draw by.
Let's get out of here.
Join us for a drop, Silver Rocker. Chip in.
Well, that was weird.
Johnny! No!
Sometimes I do wish not speaking was a more interesting option. But usually it just means that there's dialogue you don't get to hear.
Johnny! Let go of me!
That dude have swords for hands? Sure did. I guess more specifically, they popped out of his forearms. You can get that. You can get Manus blades. Cyberpunk. No, this is my... I've only finished the game completely one time, but I've played like two-thirds of it three times. Going for a different ending. Male V playthrough. It's only practical to have the silence option be low effort. That's true. Awesome.
Come on.
I think it's just there for that little spike of stress.
Been a while, Johnny boy. How long'd you say? 2 weeks since I last cobbled you up?
Or a moment where, like, it wouldn't make sense for the player to be able to pause the entire world in a situation like you're getting mugged.
Where's Ald?
Where's who?
Woman who was with me.
He brought you and you alone.
Fuck, they grabbed her.
Yeah, that weird
Nobody
guy.
Nobody saw
Looks
it.
Looks like a Resident Evil reject.
Ask your savior. Said his name was Thompson.
Arasaka, wasn't it?
It's always Arasaka with you.
Cause it always is Arasaka.
We gotta talk.
All right. It's spitting glue, but she's holding tight. Get some rest. Even a few hours, but the stitch is set at least.
Uh-huh.
Johnny. Yeah, fuck it. You won't listen anyway.
So talk.
They wanted her. You was just home.
And you just stood there, dick in hand, gawking and dreaming of tomorrow.
Would have shredded us both if I jumped in. You see the guy's reflexes? Course not, he was that fast. Tech like that, you don't find in a dumpster.
Got lucky. Lead panned out. Got some prime footage.
Too bad my lead got tossed in the back of a van that sped off. You, aim to do something about it? She was your output, wasn't she?
Not your fucking business.
Not sure, huh? Yeah. Heard there was tension, assorted goings-on. Honestly, could not care less about your fluttering hearts and loins. I want to know why Arasaka bagged her.
Alt's kidnapping, it's collateral shit. They swiped her to get at me.
You even know what she does for a living? Girl's one of the best runners around. Arasaka wants her. Abduction was a standard intercorp extraction. Nothing more.
Okay, so what are they after?
Soul Killer. An AI. Sound familiar at all?
Of course. Urban legend with the shittiest name ever.
It's no legend. Soul Killer's real. And your chumbas at Arasaka just hired the runner who wrote it. Take that in. Sokka with Soul Killer to do with as it pleases. Grim, my man. You even imagine that, Rocker? Arasaka will be unstoppable. Soul Killer will flatline any runner who comes close to even trying to scratch its ice. Seen it happen. Not an iota of physical damage. Nervous system or anywhere else. No sound, no fury, no stench. Just all of a sudden, brain waves cut out. As if someone pulled the plug.
What a steaming load of shit. Let's go.
Okay. What's your take then? I'm all ears.
Oldest, tritest tale in the world. Arasaka was out to provoke me. And it worked.
Commenting on people's clothes. Yeah, the clothes in the flashback sections are a little more ostentatious.
So what'll it be?
Because they take place in
coming with
like classic cyberpunk timeline, so it's just hyper 80s.
Tower to grab Alt right back.
Just you and me? You out of your fucking mind?
Come along. Let you watch from the sidelines. Seem to like doing that.
I'll be in the car. Can't wait too long, though.
You'll wait as long as you need to. Where the hell's Rogue? Sit. Stay.
Silverhand! Got an IOU here with your autograph on it.
You seen Rogue?
She's upstairs. But I heard you two weren't,
Brother, you heard wrong.
We're looking for a book?
Looks like a book, but it's nano, interactive, state-of-the-art, a prototype of some sort.
Nanotech. Interactive. A prototype.
Oops.
Fuck Muffin. Got no idea what it is, and he wasn't all that willing to go into it. Looks like a kid's book. Castles, skeleton keys, and King Coyote.
I think there'll be a balance between Cyberpunk 2077 and Cowboy Bebop technology-wise. I'm writing a story that is set in the future, but I'm not sure how far tech-wise I want to go with it. I mean, I'm not... Do you just mean style? Because those are just two kind of stylish science fiction settings. But no, I think the future will be a lot more mundane.
Out of my way!
There was a talk prompt. Oh, isn't doing anything?
Look, I got a meeting.
Ooh, so I've been on your mind.
Got some sugar for me?
Maybe, baby. But you gotta do something for me first.
Whatever you want. Just not this minute. I'm in a hurry. Seen Rogue around here?
No. G saw her, though. With somebody new.
Style-wise, yeah, I don't know. If people could predict that, the world would be a very different place about what fashions will come and go. I don't think that the future is going to look specifically like either of those things, though. Both Cowboy Bebop. Well, Cowboy Bebop's world wasn't quite as... I guess it is a vision of, like,
Johnny,
70s science
give
fiction.
Give me a hand here.
This is decidedly more 80s.
Heard you weren't talking to me.
Dunno. Seemed to be talking to
But it's usually a mix of something current and something old.
How about now?
I'm waiting for Y2K fashion to kind of cycle back around. And I wonder what that'll look like. Steph gives me updates sometimes from Fashion Instagram. What the? That's the first equip for Johnny's fists. I didn't know you could bring those out. It seems to have messed up the UI, too. No, whatever. Oh, Big Willy! With the VIP or band.
You know who he was talking to. I need a name. Just one.
I wish I could.
Let's see how lucky you will be.
Your first time here, isn't it? Want some advice?
Sure.
No. 2 in 1 day? You're kidding me.
No, keep it. Who the hell knows where that mouth's been?
Damn. Big Fs. Tough titties, Fs all around. Firm Fs in chat. Sorry to hear that, Big Willy. Thank you very much. Before I ban you right now, which I'm about to do, thank you. Thank you, Big Willy, for watching the stream enough to be able to get 250,000, a quarter million channel points. It takes about a year of watching. Well subbed, I think. All to this moment. Me banning you for an hour. Tragic. And it's not right. But you are banned now. You are banned now. Oh, wait a minute. I used it wrong. Wait, what? You're not banned yet. Okay, now you are banned. Now you are banned. Thank you very much for watching. Please don't leave, but you are banned for an hour. Don't leave, though. Thank you.
Silverhand. By as lonesome far as I can tell.
What? He, like, rats you out while he's right in front of you?
Johnny?
A punk.
Oh, those things, Engels?
Got a private meet going on in there.
Rogue back there, too?
Yeah, just...
Yeah, private meet, so you said. Promise to be super unobtrusive.
Oh yeah, the skyline in 2020. Other weird conversations. Some butt ass.
I need a nap. Just a short one.
Damn. Tired ass. Cyber butt.
That's
nowhere near enough. Shockwave's gonna fuck with everything within a 500-yard range.
Run faster then. D-Turner made it. No reason you shouldn't.
Wouldn't be talking to us if he could afford D. So quit pissing around the issue and fucking tell Sid he has to wait for our signal, alright?
We got a problem here?
Yeah, actually.
Pissy, come on. We just want something from us.
Well?
You guys seem rogue.
Oh, you're fucking gonked, Johnny. She'll rip your balls off.
We'll see about that. So?
Room in the back.
What, you fucking forget who you gave the job to? Or were you trying to kill the motherfucker twice, just to be sure?
Randy and his crew were fast. End of story.
So this was a fucking race?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. Got a new client paying double for express service. And I'd like to be sure I can deliver.
Well, maybe if I'd known the new rules.
Hey, we didn't know May gave you the job first either. So, A, you had a head start. And B, you're fucking amateurs.
Look at this dude's shoes, though. He's rad. Is Johnny's voice actor intentionally awkward? He has a kind of a stilted, rambling delivery. And yeah, to some degree, it's kind of hard to tell how much of that is Keanu and how much of that is his performance for this character. I think it works, because he's pretty consistent with that kind of chunky delivery. No, that's Keanu Reeves, yeah. I think it works. But that, you know... It could also just be me giving the game more credit than it deserves. But you need to give the performance more than just like a couple of line reads for it to make sense, I guess, or for it to form up as a character.
God, I hate this fucking town. Hate these slimy fucking fixers. Hate this fucking bar.
Rogue rocks though.
Where would you rather be now? I could take you away. Out to the lands where my clan roams. There aren't too many jobs out there, but we'd find some other useful ways to kill time.
Getting the weirdest deja vu now. My answer's no.
No today.
Johnny. Got too close.
Don't know you.
That's no problem. Just as long as everyone else knows Johnny Silverhand.
Rogue. Lovely surprise to see.
We're waiting for a client. One who values discretion.
Mm-hmm. So much so, he himself didn't show.
No point in sitting here, then.
You still mad about that thing?
What thing, Johnny? That you fucking lied to my face? Put my peeps on the line? Or that you were fucking three other women behind my back before we were through?
New partner?
Gotta say, that famed charm of yours? Overhyped. Or maybe just dulling with age.
You have a job for us, Rocker? Or are you mainly here to run your mouth?
Look, our history, I know. But we don't really have time for feelings.
I'm in no hurry.
I got a job. That's it. Urgent. But I got the euro.
How much?
butt out. This isn't your biz.
Niflheim Dragoon, thanks for the sub.
Rocker just pulled out his wallet.
Don't you get it? He's not here about any damn job. He's fucking with me. Last time,
you'll be smarter. Take your eddies up front. So, how much, Rocker?
It's important. Name your price.
So you're either made of money, or you think we won't live to collect. Either way, Rocker, you're coming with us.
Deal.
That it is. Urgent indeed.
Shit, Johnny. Didn't notice you had a fucking tail?
Mr. Silverhand.
You're coming with us.
Sure. Let me just finish this.
You want to play with me? Come on!
Aren't you...
Good! Keep that up!
Reload in the world. Ugh. That'll happen there?
The
cyber brain got mega hacked. I don't know.
I'm impressed. Seriously. Hilo? Is this real? Who'd you piss off this time, Johnny? Oh.
Taking heavy losses.
Is that it open? Yes, fucking own it.
That's how we're gonna play it.
Heads down. Keep it together. Shoot.
Just say get wrecked.
Let's get out of here. Not even sorry for you.
Keep up the pressure.
Yeah.
Hey, cannot be.
A little for me.
I'll take him out. Units down.
Cover me. Reloading. Elevator now! Need to blow out of here!
Keep up the
fuck in a sec!
I guess that, yeah, that's what I'm doing. Such a limp. Such a limp gun holding stance. I guess it looks pretty cool from first person.
It's gonna take much longer.
Got trouble in heaps.
There'll be more at the bottom. Bet you thou.
We're parked outside. You coming?
Thompson's waiting for me in the car.
Who?
Media, you wouldn't know it.
Everybody left their coats.
Get sliding!
Cover you!
Oh, I'm impressed! Seriously!
Man down! Take their position! Go, go, go!
Fight! Join
you in a sec! Q-Dog? You would say it's Morbin time now? Is this Morbin time for you? I suppose having a cool gun like this and getting into cyber fights is... Damn it, man. The range on that is way lower than I think. Shit.
Hold that at me.
Oh, 2 health. Woo! Alright.
Break roof! That heal will come back. You'll be back.
It's only using half its rotors.
Let's get the hell away.
We'll be right behind you.
now we're fucked.
Or even the drivers are poking out the window.
Cover you!
Not half bad, Dad.
Alright. Let's assume the rotation of the rotors is matching the FPS of what you're seeing, hence why they don't move, just like with cameras. It must be exactly what it is.
Gotta lose them quick. Next right,
the rotors are turning at a some multiple of 120 FPS. Oh, Wazul, you're coming and playing through this? How far are you?
I think we're clear of them.
I guess it's kind of hard to say, isn't it? Because you can complete a lot of the story chunks kind of in different orders.
So who we gotta pull out of Arasaka?
Alt Cunningham, netrunner from ITS.
Oh.
Just did all the gigs? Oh, yeah. Man. All the side stuff?
The tower. What's it taking her there?
This gets better by the minute. How you wanna play this? Either of you dogs got a plan?
What are you doing back there,
yep.
Buddy?
Distract him. Make some noise.
Nance. She'll know how to draw a crowd. Call on her. Set up right under Arasaka's windows and crank it loud. Blast the panes out. It'll be a gig to remember.
Start the riot! Start the riot! Come to a dash of destruction! Violence!
We have not as yet reported the exact number of people hurt in the riots. But our reporters are on the scene at Arasaka Tower. And they all agree. A psychoactive agent has been dispersed at the site, affecting those in the crowd.
All right.
Oh, man. This chunky-ass fucking camera eye. So dumb. Put on his Matrix coat.
You recording this whole thing?
Uh-huh. Why? Want to say a few words to the folks at home?
Do what you gotta do. Just stay out of my way.
His ribbon cable epaulets. Ah, that's so cool. So cool and dumb.
Thompson. Know him well?
No, why does it matter?
Don't like the guy? Don't trust him. And medias are bad luck.
What?
Bad luck. Say someone finds a tape later. A tape of us breaking into Arasaka Tower.
Worry about that if we make it out.
Come on, we don't have much time.
Okay. This song is so good.
Gotta find a way.
I deserve to live.
Ready or not, here they come.
Yes, good. Keep that up.
Grenade.
So we're gonna play it. Ready or not, here they come. Get ready.
Got four in view. Headed this way. Get ready.
I'm impressed. Seriously.
Keep.
5 seconds now. Ready.
Well, we won.
Oh, you son of a whore!
Should have made him a lefty. I thought he was. The way he plays guitar.
Hey.
But he shoots with his right.
Pretty bad. Minimize risk. Pull back.
Ah. He traded. I thought I could get him.
You fucking gum.
Yeah, corporal gum.
Unit down!
Don't hold back!
I'm impressed! Seriously!
He's really going for it.
guys aren't fine in the mainframe. What's going on here?
Surrender yourself.
Want to play with me? Come on.
Shoot it down.
Yes, fucking own it.
About to get messy.
Anyone else? Anyone?
Gotta be around here somewhere.
Hey, what's up, Pop-Tart? Welcome.
Watch extremist.
Not even sorry for you.
This is it.
Fucking door's armored so thick you can use a tank. Solutions, anyone?
Let me try. Son of a bitch!
He's tugging on it.
Try this.
Now I see why we brought him along.
Three, the journalist two, bringing one.
Perfect.
Best step back.
Grab your weapon!
Let's get to work.
Out of ammo! Reloading! Yeah. He's chipped!
Now I'm pissed off!
Guy with the glasses, see the same guy who still see the death's head BD. I guess maybe, but I doubt it. That's many years later. It's like 50 years later. Also, he's like a journalist? Some characters can live for a while, but it takes money.
I would advise you not to disturb her.
What'd you do to Alt?
I put her to work on a project of a lifetime.
Get out of my way. Hey, you hear me? Alt.
Is she?
Alt, come on, don't do this. Fuck!
Johnny.
The hell are you doing? Are you still rolling?
This is all we can do now.
Won't change her. She's not.
Ooh. This is what rage looks like. You're a rocker, and you gotta punch somebody.
There we go. Stop that! You have to kill him?
The frame's punched out of you.
We gotta go. Johnny, she's dead.
Also, the BD vendor didn't have a busted up face in current timeline, so.
Well, spit it out before you burst.
Thompson, what happened to him?
Dunno.
Did you have saved her? No. It's pretty important to the
maybe
story that happened.
To make yourself feel better.
Guy was a vulture, out to use Alt from the start. When Arasaka flatlined her, man, for him that was sprinkles, with the cherry on top. Fuck, he would have killed her himself if they hadn't, just for his cockrot story.
Cockrot.
The recording. What did Thompson do with it? It ever get released?
Fuck no.
Wow. Were you going for Dick Wipe of the Year?
The fuck you going on about?
Never mind. You sure glossed over Alt earlier.
Really? Any examples?
I don't know. That you were a couple? That she wrote Soul Killer? That she's dead? How the hell is she supposed to help us now? As a ghost?
She's not dead. Managed to escape.
I saw the body.
Alt fled. Into the net.
You're pushing bullshit. Heard more than my share of tales about runners who ran off the net.
Hold on a second. Thompson looks even crazier in the RPG. Oh, jeez. Looks like Duke Nukem. Oh, what a nerd. Nice.
Never Netland. Just never thought you'd be the next to tell me one.
Don't need you to believe me, long as you do exactly what I say.
What does the button above the joystick do? It's actually a hat switch. So it's a four-directional hat switch, and you can also click it. And just like everything else, it can map to... it maps to inputs.
Let's get out of here.
So I just have it mapped to the arrow keys, and then I can bind the arrow keys to stuff in the game.
When'd you find out?
So in this, it just goes to when different menu screens.
And?
Quests, what'd map, etc.
That she was a captain in the Arasaka subnet. But they couldn't hurt her. And she told me not to come looking for her.
What? Why?
This one time, she wanted me to just let it go. Because enough people had died for nothing already.
Huh.
So, what did you do?
Got my hands on two thermonuclear charges.
Then headed back to Arasaka Tower. And Rogue went with you. Again.
I paid her well.
Said to yourself, she was the best. Had her pick of contracts. But for some strange-ass reason, she took a job from a rocker with a death wish. A rocker forever getting his ass beat by Arasaka.
Different times, kid. Back then, mercs didn't normally sell out to corps. All you had to do was yell, "Let's fuck up Arasaka," and every last one of them jizzed their pants. Rogue included.
How do you know Alt's still around? It's been half a century, but you've spent cloistered in Mikoshi. Netwatch could have hunted her down years ago.
Oh, they tried, believe me. But their tiny corporate brains can't handle a free AI that knows how people think. They were busy looking for her in the Crystal Palace while she was building the Ghost City for King Talent.
Cyberpunk dialogue. Crystal Palace, Ghost City. But it's all like virtual? Oh, man. Come to my cyber Crystal Palace.
Voodoo boys so, think ready? They know where she is, beyond the Black Wall.
Where nobody can touch her.
Brigitte's primed to go there, break through. Just to contact Alt, talk to her.
Too much for our little pro.
Upstairs. Go upstairs in cyberspace. Is this like a stairwell? I do like the way this looks. Like twinkling stars. I'm pretty sure that's how... Well, that's. I think that's how they describe it. Or Gibson describes it in Neuromancer. Oh, come on. What is this? All right, Pop-Tart. More tales from the front lines of retail. We had the police come to the store today. Crazy man in a motorized wheelchair who reeked and was dirty as hell. Has previously been banned from the property, rolled up and started screaming for money about paying, etc. On top of it, a shoplifter at the same time. God. You're not paid enough. No one who works there probably is.
A moment.
Sure felt like more than a moment. Saw a good chunk of Johnny's life. And Alt.
A It is possible. Data connected to Alt are linked to a strong memory trace in the construct. Very strong. These memories must have evoked a powerful emotional response, then projected onto your consciousness.
Emotion, yeah. Plenty of that. Construct, what kind of shape's it in?
Enough data is uncorrupted to convince Alt it is authentic.
What the hell does that mean? So, did it work?
Yes. We extract the necessary fragment of Silverhand's engram. We are ready now to make contact with Alt. First, we must dive deeper.
Oh. It's gonna be great to... I've really enjoyed some of the transitions and effects because, with the exception of the two very stuttery sequences, they've all been really buttery smooth. This game's been running really well.
Beyond, there are no
borders. Whoa.
None have yet returned. She will be the first.
So, actually, you've got no idea what's beyond that thing.
But we will know soon.
And these shapes I'm seeing.
Wild, unfettered AI, searching for a passage.
I held up my end of our deal. Your turn. Before you pass through that wall, I want Johnny's psyche removed.
We will not pass through. You will take the code to the other side.
Fuck. Might have guessed. Never had any intention of helping me, did you?
It does not matter anymore. You will bring all to its end.
Don't got much for options, do I?
Ali.
Get to the other side. Brigitte. Alt!
Joris, Yapataki Networkla.
What the hell is going on?
They breached our BBSs. We have nothing to do with this.
Netwatch.
What?
Oh, right. I forgot that that happened while you were in cyberspace.
Netwatch cannot touch me here.
It's really you. What happened out there? Couldn't just take him out?
Netwatch was well prepared this time.
Gotta be Mosley the fucker.
What if Brigitte and the Voodoo Boys?
I was forced to purge them. Netwatch was exploiting their BBS.
Purge? You mean they're dead, all of them?
Not actually gonna feel bad for them, are ya?
Damn it. I brought Netwatch here. Agent I dealt with must have slipped me a tracker that let him right in.
Switched things up on the sly, replacing the Voodoo's virus with his own brand of rot.
Probably how they got to you.
It matters not. The entire subnet was destroyed.
Alt, you pulled us out of there. That mean you and us were okay? Everything's chill?
I have recognized your engram code, but I do not know why you are here.
So you can pay me back for getting you out of our socket tower. V, this is Alt. Best Netrunner Night City's ever seen. Alt, this is V. You need to save his life.
As you can see, Johnny's got it all thought out. But there's the question of what you'll want in return.
Netwatch propaganda has been effective. Do you see me as a demon who requires a pact signed in blood?
Listen, I'm just trying to survive.
I cannot help you.
Can't or won't?
Can't. To attempt to do so, I would need access to more advanced technology.
Nah, she's not really even human anymore.
What? But it's your tech. You created Soul Killer.
Yeah.
The program I created has little in common with how Arasaka has since repurposed it.
Fine, so how about Mikoshi? That advanced enough for you?
If I could gain access to Mikoshi, it would cease to exist.
Good, we can work with that. We'll get you inside Mikoshi and you'll help V, deal?
Best runner Night City's ever seen can't bust into Mikoshi on her own?
I am a well-known threat there. They have a layer of black ice with my name on it. Literally.
Kinda like a custom-made prison jumpsuit.
I refuse to be caged in there ever again.
What can you do for me, exactly?
With the Soul Killer resident inside Mikoshi, I will create a construct of you, then disentangle your neural network from Johnny's. I shall then inject your engram back into your mortal form.
So, you'll save my life, but flatline me along the way.
Your consciousness, neural engrams, will be recorded as data. The rest will cease to exist.
The rest?
The soul. I did not grant the program its name, but Soul Killer does precisely what it promises to do.
Christ, I don't want to listen to this bullshit. V just hops back into his body, right? Nothing changes.
Everything changes. You know this well.
Man. I disliked how people reacted to becoming the AI. I saw it as an absolute win. Yeah, I think...
Your appearance here, an unnecessary...
Asking people about that is essentially asking, is there like an undefined... Is there an undefined and even divine aspect to life, to an individual, to the soul? Real ship of Theseus paradox? A little bit, yeah. I like that Alt is specifically saying, no, there's a soul and you lose it. You'll know. You know when it's not there, which is a really interesting way to describe it. So it's like Soma? Yeah, Soma deals with that a lot. About like which copy is you and what you even means. Soma's so good.
Right,
I love Soma.
But how will you reach Mikoshi?
Like actual identity terror. Existential terror. That's the best kind.
There's your problem.
Ones that go after your idea of self.
The human factor. We'll crack a window, slip you into Mikoshi.
Johnny, embellishes, in case you hadn't noticed. You don't trust him, which is fine. But you have my word, we'll slip you inside Mikoshi while keeping you out of harm's way.
I believe this human factor and I have things in common.
Is some a book, an anime? No, it's a game. You're not good with scary stuff. Is it scary or is it just tense? It's tense, I guess. It's not like high volume. It's not always screaming at you or like showing you disturbing imagery.
So, we agreed?
Yes, we are agreed. Find a path into Mikoshi. I shall prepare a program to help you navigate the local net.
How will I contact you once I'm ready?
This is a BBS address. It will be our secure communication channel.
Alt.
Yeah, I guess there's a lot of like underwater claustrophobia type stuff.
Just you and me.
No, that will not be possible.
Nah, I'm not into that. Oh man, we got a ghetto bird.
Couldn't think of a.
I used to hear those all the time when I lived in Koreatown. They're not very, very common around here.
As much as it tickles me too, we got a Delta.
Right, still got Mr. Grumps left.
Oh man. Oh. She wipes them all out. Yeah, I guess Alt did. But because Netwatch was snooping around. I thought Netwatch fried everybody. But, I guess Alt did it, just to keep things tidy. But if you don't rat out the voodoo boys, then they don't show up, and all the voodoo boys are alive when you leave. I mean, the voodoo boys don't really matter too much after this. They're kind of written out of the story for obvious reasons, but... Killed them because I was sick of them fucking with me? Can you just pull out a gun and shoot them here? I usually just... Oh, shit. I usually just let the voodoo boys survive. They're not happy with me, huh? Beat them all to death with a crowbar? Nice. Jeez. That's pretty metal. Of course, I'm getting hacked. Netwatch sounds like another name for MediaTek. Not a bad idea. Don't worry. I'll dismantle in a minute. But I'm making some money off this, goddammit. Gotten the secret ending. No, that's my goal this time. My destination is the secret ending. You guys can hear the helicopter sometimes. I see it coming through my mic a little bit. It's really loud. This is perfect, by the way. This is the most immersive gameplay. Helicopter hovering over your place? Yeah, I mean, in my neighborhood, it's like it's doing loops. Usually that happens when there's a foot chase or somebody has run from the police and they want to get eyes on them. I called it a ghetto bird. Oh shit. I didn't know you fought Placid up here. That rules. Damn, I gotta use the restroom though. I've been waiting since everything's been so cinematic. Alright, I gotta step away for just a second. I'll be right back, sorry. Alright, everything's fine. The helicopter's gone. But there was some shit. There was some shit going down. I went outside, and like one block over, there were cops that had like cut the road off. But the helicopter, you know, picked up and left. So I assume everything's all in control now. Somebody had a bad night. I think they're looking after me for gaming too hard. They were close on my trail, but I had to take care of some stuff. I had to go take care of the situation. This music effing rips. E and Q. E. I'm probably gonna need like just instant health. Yeah, we'll go with this one. EMP's probably good. Just chain stun him, shoot him to death. How long did it take you to get used to that rig? It's kind of a complicated answer, really. I want to say it depends on the game, but for this one, I want to say it feels pretty natural after like 2 to 3 hours. There's still bits where you have to think about it or you'll hit the wrong button. I still have to kind of keep training myself out of bad habits sometimes. But I'm getting there. The compounding factor is that I use it like once a month. If I really am honest with myself, that's the frequency that I've been playing this, and this is the only game I use it for. There's some other games I would like to use it for, I guess. It would be cool to, you know, to swap Doom Eternal or Final Fantasy 14 over to this. But that is intimidating. I've hit a skill level with those games that just, I don't know if I'm strong enough to like roll it back. And I'm not sure that it's worth it to do that, even though this is very comfortable. Like my hand does feel just more rested and comfortable using it. I'm never uncomfortable enough using a keyboard, but I can feel a difference. It does feel like my left hand's floating on a cloud. Like my right hand, I can feel is just a teeny tiny bit more strained, just using my mouse and sort of like gripping it and stuff. It's the closest we can get. The whole brain outro into a controller. Yeah, that's the goal, right? Is to plug a big ass cable right to the base of your skull and then just be in the game or something like that. I've wondered about that. If we can do full sensory immersion, are there people who would still just prefer to play with a controller? I think so, just for old time's sake. But I also think the game experiences will be different. Like, if you can actually feel a game, you can like feel yourself get out of breath or feel pain. I guess it'll just be experiences that are mostly like masturbatory. Those things probably won't be there. I feel like inducing selective emotions is a whole way to a whole new kind of like art form, I guess. If you actually have that power. Put a chip in me, let's get the future going already. You can do that. There are chips now. They just don't do that. But what they do would have been considered like hyper science fiction 20 years ago. That's a brain dance? Yeah. You are somebody else. Oh, look at him. What the fuck, man? I gotta shoot you sometime, brother. I can walk in. What? Even... Oh, there we go. He's bound by, like, stamina and stuff too, right? Anyway, this is not an interesting fight we got going on. Stupidest Matrix fight in the world. I don't think it's hitting him. I don't think it hit him.
Yeah.
What was the song used in the last MediaTek clip? I don't know. Sorry to say, I don't know. I might be able to find the YouTube video that it came from, and that might have a track list. But as you can see, I'm deep into some video games right now. Guys, you can dodge bullets, can't dodge melee. So it's weird. I've only done a hacking run. I've done a hacking run and a melee, like a melee third of a run, really. So I've never actually used guns yet. This is the first time I'm seeing or dealing with characters that can dodge bullets. And I guess you just do this. It just makes it take way longer. The music was so good, though. Oh, you get his coat? Aww. They should take it off of his model when you take it. So I got 500 credits for that. Okay, yeah, the reward is 500. Damn. I passed up 15,000 eddies, I'm pretty sure, by not fighting the boss. Or by not fighting Sasquatch. And there's not infinite money in this game either, I don't think. Well, I guess you can like grind items. But it's not easy to come across money at some point. That's what I'm kind of hoping. Also, I feel like if an expansion can come in and add like 30 like pretty good money making events, that'll help a lot. It'll like grease the wheels. You'll be able to buy way more cars. I guess it depends if an expansion adds tons of that stuff too. Who knows? Oh yeah, I gotta escape. I should craft while I'm here. Did it.
Yes.
Oh wait, he's still squirming. No. No, not like that. There we go. Oh, access points. Yes. The weird little like gold chests hidden around. I forgot about those. Does that end up being significant money?
Hey, look. See that? Fuck those cunts.
You watching a story on the Arisakas or narrating porn?
Gee, aren't you funny? Look around. Look what they've done to this hood.
This is the part where you divulge your master plan to annihilate Arisaka?
No. It's the part where I say I despise petty merc thieves who think they're hot shit rebels after setting foot in the afterlife. Might think you took on Arisaka, but you're just a bug they scraped off the sole of their boot and tossed in the trash.
I feel like this is a rep earning ability.
Let's get out of here.
But I also want to like provoke good dialogue out of him.
You fucking pitiful petty clipper.
Jesus.
Know what? Afraid I don't got time for chit-chat.
Lacking the balls. That's your problem.
It's got
exactly no rep in this town and the chooms to match.
Still got better prospects than a carbon copy ghost of a washed-up rocker boy locked in a trinket.
Your last prospect was to net some eddies on a stolen biochip. Remember how that went?
You're a dick, you know.
And you're a cunt. Maybe we'll fit together after all.
One of the best lines in the game. Holy shit.
You seem to know a lot about my past.
Well, seeing flashes of your past. Just like you've seen flashes of mine.
Pisses me off that our memories blend.
Don't have my own anymore. Ship's the worst thing that ever fucking happened to me.
Mean to say I haven't earned the top spot yet.
An arrogant asshole's no small problem, but it ain't my biggest. Dying is.
Death by becoming someone else. You didn't do anything to deserve that fate.
My memories. What do they feel like?
Not following you.
Aside from what you see and hear, I mean. You process or experience any feelings?
Anger, regret, bitterness, fear. Though honestly, can't tell if they're yours or mine.
You afraid of death?
I'm afraid of wasted opportunities.
Like Arasaka Tower?
Came through it, as you can see. And I ain't done with them yet. So, you ready?
Your goal's to bury Arasaka. Demolish it. Mine's to stay above ground. Seem pretty clearly defined, both.
Actually aligned pretty nicely, too. You need Mikoshi to save your life? That done, I can burn it to the ground.
There it is. The crusade. Get to Mikoshi, smash the system.
Okay. I'll tell you why I want to destroy Arasaka, but I'll only tell you once.
Gear up for a stupid speech.
All right.
I saw a corpse strip farmers of water, and eventually of land. Saw them transform Night City into a machine fueled by people's crushed spirits, broken dreams, and empty pockets.
Getting all worked up. I stand up, getting all mad.
Corps have long controlled our lives, taken lots, and now they're after our souls.
Might be right. Can't really argue with you there.
I gotta amp him up.
Declared war not because capitalism's a thorn in my side or out of nostalgia for an America gone by. This war's a people's war against a system that spiraled out of our control. It's a war against the fucking forces of entropy. Understand? Do whatever it takes to stop them, defeat them, gut them. If I gotta kill, I'll kill. If I need your body, I'll fucking take it. Fucking hell. You still don't see it. But you will one day.
God. Rock! Yeah, the ad is so perfectly placed, isn't it? Can't beat that. I just had a whole conversation with a ghost. I wonder if people give me the eye. Alright. I wonder. Oh, excuse me. Where is one up, right? Oh, 10%? Come on, we had a moment. Aggravating. Actually, since I just did a lot of shooting. I do throw grenades a lot. But I guess there's stuff that lets you loot more things. I think I'm just gonna keep stacking handgun. Oh, there is this. That's important. Yeah. Just a brainstorm, but put Johnny Depp and Keanu Reeves, cyberpunk movie, would watch that shit. Has Johnny Depp done science fiction? I like to think it's half in his head, half ranting on the street. Yeah, it's curious how the game is never explicit about how V's interactions with Johnny play out. I don't think anyone seems to react to V's talking to Johnny, so that might just be like a head thing. Okay. Right. Let me take stock of things for a second. We got 11,000. Oh, let me sell some stuff. Let me find a place to do that. Right around the corner. Wonderful. Wait a minute. Wait. I've already wrecked my car. Wait, I was looking the right way. Okay. Be like one or two movies? Yeah, I can't. None come to mind, but I'm not an expert. The audio for V's lines to Johnny seem to have a bass echo or something when I play on headphones, like he's talking without opening his mouth. Okay. Congratulations. Oh, back to this. Yeah, maybe he's just thinking at Johnny then. So, I guess it's somebody like sitting with a 1,000-yard stare and a very intense expression, staring at the ocean. Just like selling stacks and stacks of dead people's clothes. Man. Another day. Right. Made a little wad of cash there. That's good stuff. Damn. Alright. Well, I gotta wear that. That's cool as hell. Still helmet. Okay. That certainly made the rest of my outfit a little less punchy, but I guess I can work with it. God forgive me. Ah, you know what? It works. You know what? It works. I got pretty lucky there. Okay. The hand cam showing my cool cyberpunk controller, which there's actually not a whole lot going on there because I don't know, cyberpunk is not a game you have to hit a lot of buttons to play compared to some other more intense games I tend to play. All right, cool, more cash. I want to just drive around for a bit. I had quite a bit of shooting. I could go for some driving. John, 76. Thanks for the prime. How do you like the claw? Just totally caved and got one. I like it quite a bit. I think it's super comfy. I think there are some things that are unfortunate that are kind of out of the claw's control. The flickering of the inputs. Like, that's something that would be nice to have a solution for. Well, I know there may be one, but I wouldn't know how to begin. Like, I guess I could try just Googling it, but such a unique intersection of problems. Why is there any... What's going on? Okay, I need to figure out. Let's do a side job. These all used to be super difficult, so I can just do these now. Make some money. And I need to get cyberware. I need to be able to bounce a bullet off of somebody and off of something and hit someone in the head. Here's the full sequence of things that I need to be able to do. Put it like this. I need to run, then slide. Enter Matrix slow-mo. Pull out my gun. Maybe my gun can already be drawn. Would be cooler if it wasn't. Pull out my gun. Aim. Aim a shot. Bounce it off the wall. Headshot. Drop somebody while I'm sliding. That's my cyber dream for this character. Attainable, I think. I would like to be able to do that regularly. That's my signature move. Yeah, Max Payne, basically. But, like, even Max Payne didn't have bullet ricochets. So this is some wanted video game era stuff, I guess. Wait, what? I'm trying to think of games that let you aim ricochets. Ooh.
Well, you found me. Congratulations. Was it worth it?
On a scale from 1 to 6? I'd say I'm sitting at a strong 6.
I guess we both know what's going to happen next.
Delamain misses you. I'm here to shut you down.
Your specimen has been processed, and we are now ready to begin the test proper.
Really appreciate it if you didn't make this difficult.
I have a surprise waiting for you after this next test. Telling you would spoil the surprise, so I'll just give you a hint. I'm going to kill you, and all the cake is gone.
Oh, we do love those references. There's actually a fair number of, like, video game culture references in this game. Like, Kojima is straight up in it.
I honestly...
Ooh! Oh, right. I fell for it.
Okay, that's enough.
Lafina! Kill him!
You chose this path. Now
down
I have
to
a surprise
the
for
steel
you.
And leather!
Deploying surprise in 5, 4... Let's see.
Shit.
Look deep into your newly blackened hearts and tell me what you see. Actually, don't.
We win or we die.
Didn't expect a firefight like that. Oh yeah, I forgot about all the mods. I gotta sell some of those. Okay, you.
Either you shut down, or I'll turn you into a scrap heap.
Oh. Here come the test results. You are a horrible person. I'm serious. That's what it says. A horrible person. We weren't even testing for that.
Going back to Delamain really so scary. You gotta drag this out.
Ooh.
I let you survive this long because I was curious about your behavior. Well, you've managed to destroy that part of me. A bitter, unlikable loner, whose passing shall not be mourned.
You know, this psyche vow might have felt more credible if you hadn't just tried to flatline me earlier.
What's your point, anyway? Survival? You're still shuffling around a little. But believe me, you're dead.
How do you...
The talking is over. I'm going back.
Oops.
I've made contact with the missing vehicle.
Definitely the oddest of the bunch.
Yes, particularly impertinent, that one. A share of your fee is being processed.
Oh, that's right. Street cred will unlock more stuff. I keep forgetting about that. I actually looked at the map and I was like, geez. Or I looked at my quest list and I was like, man, I don't have that much to do. Then I forgot that fixers slowly roll out quests to you now, so you just have to trust that more content pop up. I never actually played the game with that adjustment. I guess it's interesting. I didn't really think about that. How has this game changed since launch? A lot of ways, I guess, large and small. I was just discussing one of them. When the game originally launched, they basically, as soon as you went into a new area, the fixer would drop like 5 or 6 quests on you. So there was a lot to do. But I guess it seemed like it was just kind of like this disorganized shotgun blast of random stuff. Which is kind of what it is. They're like side quests, right? So they kind of changed it so they unlock slowly. Oh, more slowly over the course of the game. You'll just be doing stuff and then Pixar will call you with like one new quest instead of dumping like 5 or 6 on you as soon as you get to their area. Ooh. Game hasn't crashed for you in any way? It's smoother? Well, I was always on PC, and it really wasn't that bad on PC. I would say the game's crashed like 5 or 6 times total. It was pretty, it was moderately glitchy when it launched. Like a model out of place, maybe one time an hour.
No, just here to reset you.
Guess I'll have to do it myself then.
Whoa, easy, easy.
Ooh.
That's hurt you.
I don't know what that was.
I am.
Why?
Ooh,
why decommiss yourself?
Because I'm a damn car in a world of humans. Ugly as sin, no prospects for the future, intimidated on the streets by punks like you.
There are other ways out besides suicide.
What, therapy? A colossal waste of time. Shrinks hate vehicles. We don't have mothers.
Could go back into the fold, rejoin the network, you know, one big happy family.
Delamain detests me.
If I recall correctly, you had very few issues until you got the first patch, then the bugs and problems came in. The 1.0 was pretty stellar for me on PC. And then, by my perception, it did actually seem to get a little glitchier. The visuals, to me, got like a 5% degrade. It actually kind of did look like it rolled back a little bit. But it ran a lot more predictably. I would say these days, it looks as good as it did at launch, and it runs way better. So, where it is right now is kind of the best of all the versions that seem to have come along. But the difference between them all, experientially, has been pretty minor. Like, one build of the game will feel like just a little more stable in terms of frame rate, but maybe that frame rate's just a little bit lower. Another time, it'll feel like the lighting is just a little bit off, a little bit blobbier, or like, there was a recurring issue with eyes. They wouldn't be lit right in various scenes. So, like, something like that can feel like it has way more of an impact than something very minor in another part of the game, so... It's all been an interesting kind of wash, but it feels stellar now and looks really, really good. Think the DLC will be any good? I think so, because I've loved everything CDPR has made. Well, I appreciated The Witcher 1. I appreciated The Witcher 1. I don't think I liked it, but I appreciated it. I respected it. And I like The Witcher 2, and I really, really like The Witcher 3. So, and I really, really, really liked Cyberpunk. So, I mean, unless they've had a complete talent turnover in the people that make the game, shouldn't say it that way, creative talent, the writing and stuff like that. As long as they're still there, I'm really interested to see what they have to say or the content that they make. We'll see. We'll see. Yeah, we still need Fat Geralt in 1992. You're 100% right. We do. I need to dedicate like a day. Man, I'm getting distracted. I've thought about later this month when I go to Games Done Quick, I'm going to see if I can take my editing bank of media tech stuff with me so I can edit a lot of clips out while I'm sitting there in the crowd or while I'm in my room. And then that way it's like I can cross stitch or I'm like knitting while I'm watching the show. Oh, you sent me the clip? Well, I want to get it in higher quality. Although I guess it's going to get broadcast back through Twitch, so why does it matter? But yeah, no, it's just a question of throwing it into Premiere and like I'm twiddling with the volume, throwing a layer on it. Have you found the Blade Runner Easter egg? I don't know. I don't think so.
Just want daddy to love you, that it?
You're a cunt.
You know what I mean. If you didn't care about Dell, he wouldn't be the topic of conversation, would he?
You may be right. I guess I haven't tried just talking to him. Fine, I'll go back.
Angry teen car.
Control of the vehicle restored, and I thank you.
You ought to show this one some love. Just saying.
Apologies. I simply don't understand. And fear I've no time to ask. Other more urgent tasks require my attention.
You're an absent father, that's what I mean.
I see. Anyway, a share of
your... I see. I forgot. I don't even remember that interaction. Oh, man. All right, let's mix up the station a little bit. Oh wait, oops. There we go. I did see there were some mods for some new radio stations, but man, I am just super not even tired of the music in the game. It's so good. This is a really good mission to listen to the radio too.
Have a look around.
That's right, it's the grime song. This is a good song. I like this one a lot. Cyber Psycho.
Beep, beep, motherfucker!
Hey, let's talk.
I'm not dying back. Hear me? Never. Try to take me and I'll crush you.
Let's see who crushes who.
Doing, dude. Ah! Ah! Shit. Stop it! Ah! I feel like this would be fun. You just really piss at your friend.
This is N54 News with a breaking story. A cyber psycho attack. Springs.
Yeah, Pop-Tart, thank you very much. That'll make it really easy. I basically am going to load up like a micro SD card with a whole bunch of source media
arrived. 35 people were pronounced dead at the scene, and another 20 remain in critical condition.
I can put that on there.
The Implant Manufacturers Association has issued a statement in response to the incident, stating, quote, "Our thoughts and prayers go to the victims and their families. We at the IMA extend our sincerest condolences in the wake of this unavoidable tragedy." End quote. River Mall Administration has announced plans to reopen the Grundy. They have offered a 50% discount at participating stores to the families of the victims. Stay tuned to N54 News for developments on this story.
Tires out. One second. Jesus, dude.
I've relinked to the vehicle. Thank you. A share of your fee is in your account.
All right. I guess it all worked out. What this tiny guy? Tiny guy. There wasn't anyone in there. I guess they ran. Yeah. I wasn't feeling it, but now I am. Shit. Oh. Look at that dude. Making noodles.
Earth?
Hold on a second.
No, from Picasso to Da Vinci, Pikmin to Maple.
Day in Night City, huh? It's like three in there. Oh, what's this? Who's this guy? Oh, he's getting arrested. Final record does not exist, or you do not have permission to view it. What's that all about?
Try that again. Just try it.
I was hoping I could like snap his neck out from under her and see what would happen.
Back off.
Oh, she's mad now. Wait, what? What? Where are you going? Uh-oh.
Attention all NCPD subcons. APB out for suspected organized crime activity on Skyline South. Primary target is Denzel Cryer, aka The Brain. Cryer leads a subgroup of the so-called Animals Gang, known to traffic the illegal supplement commonly called juice. City's got a reward on offer for neutralizing Cryer and his entourage.
Why does she keep looking at me like that? Oh. Where are we going? Actually, let me see if I can... Okay. The dispatch missions don't show up. In the quest, they just kind of show up on the map. I think it's like, I think that's what they're referring to.
You're in my way. Back off. You're in my way.
Oh my gosh, people do the little like scuttle to get through the crosswalk. I've never seen that before. What's going on here? I don't know. I'm curious where she's headed. Is she just kind of like walking in random directions? Great. Dude was just pissing. Big time pissing. Okay, she's back. He's so mad. Was she going back to the dude? She wasn't there the whole time? What does this mean? What the fuck, man? Teleported away. This dude's still like, don't invest me though. Oh no, don't frisk me. Don't do it. No. Defunded in real time. Here we go. Now we're talking. Weird day. Been a weird day. Oops, that's not my car. Well. Yeah, it is. Vomiting, pissing, getting arrested, yeah. Winking out of existence. Oh. Whoa. Ha. Ha. Whoa. Ooh. Ha. Ooh. Ooh. Just a little adjustment. Back on track. Blink out of existence, or did she hack your eyes? Ooh, yeah, I got hacked. Oh, shit. No, she's long gone by now. I can't believe my eyes got hacked. Ooh! Man, Cyberpunk's so cool. What's great about Cyberpunk is that it's always consistent. Even when characters are just disappearing in front of your eyes, there's a perfectly rational in-universe explanation.
Since we're gonna work together, only right to say hello. They call me El Capitan.
Where all the cars go?
They call you.
See, no introductions necessary. I already took care of that.
Someone comes to me with biz, I take care of it. I eat, sleep, and breathe biz. Remember that.
Aye, aye, Captain.
While we're at it, need fresh wheels, bikes. I got it all. Real good prices. So hit me up anytime, you hear?
little wall ride there. Let me read these text messages. I forgot that, like, you get the little conversations when you go actually talk to the fixers. It's always really interesting. Shit fell on my car.
Thanks, I'll try to find it and reset.
PTSD from the frequent calls. Yeah, I actually turned the calls back on. Because you can turn off the fixer and the NY or NCPD calls now. And just get text messages instead. So that's a good adjustment too. Pretty directly addressing what a lot of people had a problem with.
I have a wife, please!
Jesus Christ. Shit. Not as overpowered as I thought it was. Dead Trooper, thank you for the resub. Just started my fourth playthrough of 2077. I was excited to start over and try a new route and build. Yeah, it's been different. Alright, well, maybe I can run over. Oh, look at that. Somebody was even asking if we go see Judy. I'm gonna play it. I'm gonna play it a little prickly. God, this music is so tight. If I can kill these guys.
What? Come on! Give me a clear shot! Let's have some fun! No! Medic! Losing. Fire!
You're exhausted, have an early shift tomorrow. Damn, sorry to hear that, but sleep well. Yeah, it's okay. I'm gonna hang up the stream here in a second anyway. Oh wow, I didn't know that I was so low on life. Damn. But yeah, I'm just so everybody else knows, I'll be wrapping it up pretty soon here because it's getting late. I gotta keep to a schedule so that I can just wake up and stream tomorrow. You gonna play Street Fighter 6? Oh yeah, yeah. I don't know how much, if I'm being realistic, but yeah. I like Street Fighter. And what little I've seen, or what little I understand of the combat system does sound really appealing to me. I like the idea of being able to turn pressure into meter. I like the idea of they're not really being like safe pressure, because you're going to be giving your opponent meter and giving them options. I like that a lot. I've never been a big fan of just spamming safe offense. Alright. There's a fair amount of that. I play Guilty Gear a little bit. Guilty Gear is a little too complicated. Like, I always felt like I'm not super great at even Street Fighter. I need a game that's like maybe less technically less of a technical requirement. But Guilty Gear is fun. I played a little bit of Strive. What's the controller you're using? I have like Demanding. Yeah, thank you. That's the one I'm looking for. Sorry, I'm getting a little spacey. I'm getting hungry. I haven't eaten in a while. My controller, I have this like USB controller that I've used for a long time. It's back there. It still works. You know, it's basic, but it works. Here, I have to. Did I get credit for this? Usually you have to, like, loot something specific. But I thought I did. Yeah, it's usually that. I guess I can check the map, which would be that. Yeah, okay. Alright, let me just find this Delamain, and then I will wrap the stream up. Before that, let me say thank you all very much for watching. Very much enjoy sharing video games with people.
For those who prefer to watch from home, it will be live streamed at the address you see at the bottom of your screen.
Let's see here. Ooh!
Events organizer, Capital Corrections.
Tomorrow, we're starting to get the, as well as attractive the video game conferences. Limited Run Games is doing theirs tomorrow, I believe.
Charter Hill Residence.
Theirs is mostly old stuff, but their conferences are great. They always have a really goofy sense of humor. Very fourth wall breaking kind of stuff.
Significant risk to human health.
So, I'm going to be restreaming that. That should be fun. Oh, Jesus. I came into a very bad part of town. What the fuck? Whoa! Oh! Jesus. Our Force Friday's back. Yeah, actually, they've been back for a while. Finished up Star Wars Bounty Hunter last Friday. Excellent, excellent game. I really enjoyed it. Now we're up to Star Wars Episode II, Attack of the Clones. A game that has the same title as the film.
Hey, I don't think I know you.
The Game Boy Advance.
Claire. Might not remember me. Bartender at the afterlife?
Uh-oh. Forgot to close my tab?
Far as a buzz about you lately. As the merc who's reliable, gets things done. And since I need help...
Okay.
Need a driver for street races. Drop by my auto shop. I'll tell you more.
Your garage, where is it?
In Arroyo, on Valley. Lovely spot. Can't miss it.
All right. I'll try not to.
If I'm not there when you arrive, just hang. I'll show up after my shift at the after.
Okay. See you, Claire.
Boudreaux. Sorry if you've had to answer the RTX question a bunch. What is the RTX question? It's on. It's turned all the way up, if that's what the question is. Boomer. Yeah, I have finished Star Wars Obi-Wan. That was the one before Bounty Hunter. That was also pretty good, but maybe a little more troubled. Definitely has more quirks. Alright, well, maybe I'll find Delamain next time. This is so cool. Pod Racers next? No. Well, next is the Game Boy Advance Episode 2 Attack of the Clones game. That's the next one. And then I think Lego Star Wars might be the one after that. Yeah, the original Lego Star Wars. Wait, I think the original is... The original Lego Star Wars is original trilogy only, though, I thought. Let me see. Alright, well, the next one is just called The Clone Wars, which is, I believe, a, like, vehicle combat game that came out on PS2. So, that's what's after Attack of the Clones. And then, Racer Revenge. And then Jedi Starfighter. Oh, geez, Star Wars, Lego Star Wars is 1, 2, 3? But it came out before Episode 3, I thought. Okay, wait, maybe Lego... Okay, Lego Star Wars is way further down. Never mind. Yeah. Yep. Okay, my bad. It is 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so it'll be interesting to go back to the original Lego Star Wars, because I remember that game just being a real breeze. Like, just a super fun time. Lego 2 is 4, 5, 6. Ah, okay. All right, thank you. Yep. Well, then... That one counts, and two does not. That also means that Skywalker Saga does count. Alright, well, thanks for watching, everybody. Again, really appreciate it, and hope to see you again in a future stream. Yeah, let me check my schedule. That's what I got my phone for. So yeah, tomorrow, Limited Run Game starts at 1 o'clock, and then after that, that's right, tomorrow is a Final Fantasy 14 day. I'm going to be doing some prep work because I have a raid group and we're going to try some hard stuff. We're going to do some extreme encounters. So if you want to see what higher level Final Fantasy 14 content looks like, feel free to give that a look. I've been tweaking the look of the game a little bit to try to make it a little more stream friendly. I found the floating numbers, turned them off, good stuff. But that's what's tomorrow. So can you wave goodbye on the hand cam? I sure can. Goodbye. Wave bye both. A little bye-bye. All right. Have a good night, and I'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.